studio mode?
Yeah, just hit minimize. Actually, that's all you have to do.
Yes.
Yep. There we go. I will be at 7.
Are you at 17 or 19?
I'm just trying to decide on what you're going to take.
I'll try and help out as best I can.
So we will go to 17.
Okay. All right.
We will cast visions.
Hold on.
Serum visions.
Have you drawn yet?
No, I haven't. I've just cast it. After fetching. I fetch.
Yeah.
Cast. Sorry.
Vault, tap, Aether Vial.
Yep.
Pass turn.
Go ahead.
Okay. Untap, tick up.
Yep.
Attack for 2.
I'll be at 8 for 15.
All right.
Good.
Fast turn.
Ritual.
Okay. Storm up to 1.
Storm 1, 3 mana.
Okay.
Metamorphos. Good.
Okay.
Got a 2 blue storm counter, 2 draw card.
What's this?
Guessing given.
Search your library for up to 4 cards with different names, reveal. Okay, actually. Let's go ahead and do. How many cards do you have now? I'm sorry.
3.
3, 1 mana.
Oh, 1 red floating. Steam Vents untapped.
1 mana floating and Steam Vents untapped. Okay. How are you separating
you pick
the piles?
2 to go in my hand and 2 to go in the graveyard.
That's right. Okay, graveyard. Graveyard. Graveyard?
Sure.
Hand. You have 3 mana in your pool?
I have
1.
Okay,
so you have 2
one
total.
Red. Ritual.
Alright.
From counter 4. And go up to 3 mana.
3 mana.
Ritual again. Storm counter 5. Go up to 5 mana.
Okay.
Spend 4 mana. Cast Fast and Flames.
Counter. Let's go. Let me just double check. I'm pretty sure this is what I need to hit. My graveyard gain flashback until end of turn. Yeah. Okay, counter, sacking, rejury.
Yeah, I'm gonna remand it.
You're gonna remand it?
No, remand the force of negation. Yeah, you still exile this.
Hold on. Counterpart spell. That spell, okay. Let's do. How many cards in hand? Two?
Two.
One in pool.
Yep.
One in pool. Force. Let's sack Trickster.
Sure.
Okay.
Maybe it's exiled as well.
Alright. Two. Okay. Take two.
Go ahead.
Untap, untap. Draw a card. Tick up.
Can I read Force Negation real quick?
Yeah, of course.
It's on your turn. I may exile a blue card.
These are exiled.
Yeah. Yeah, oh yeah. Well, I have no way to bring them back, so I usually don't differentiate.
Gotcha.
But yeah, I can't bring anything from my graveyard back. Unless you have interaction in that way. Let's do... Tap.
Flash in.
Silphergill.
Sure.
Draw a card. I don't need to pay the cost. How many cards? Still just two. Okay, I'm sorry.
You're good.
Attack for two.
Yep. I'll be at 13.
All right, pass turn.
Go ahead.
Okay. Oh, pass turn?
Yep, yeah, pass.
Okay. Untap, untap. Tap. Leave it two. Vault. Tap. Attack for four.
Block the silver gill.
Okay.
Take two. Go to 11.
Pass turn.
Go ahead.
And tap. For two.
Nine.
Pass turn.
Fetch it instead.
Go to one, or lose one.
Yeah, I'll be at eight.
All right.
I did what you said.
Master?
Sure.
Attack for...
Three.
Attack for three.
Be at five.
Pass turn.
Cast Serum Visions.
Alright. Stormlight one.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, you didn't need to pay, did you?
It's still one mana. It only reduces by
five.
Oh,
that's right. Sorry.
I grave shot this twice.
How many cards in hand after grave shot? Two.
Two.
Super tempted. Are you, you're storming it?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, storm trigger targeting that as well.
Just for two. Fuck it, let's go for it. Force? Pay cost?
What's that?
Pay full cost.
Yeah.
For the force?
Yeah.
Okay.
It's good.
So it takes one.
Yep. Go ahead.
Okay. And tap. Storm is scary.
Yeah.
Especially like at that point. Like I only have one creature. Is there a way just to reset?
Yeah. No.
Just add it back?
Yeah. Just so you know, my proxies are just planes and they're Chalice of the Void. Okay.
Thank you.
Why are you playing this version of Storm as opposed to the Lotus Fields?
It's more consistent.
Is it?
Much more
consistent. Why are people playing Lotus Field Storm?
Because it's fun.
Because it's fun. It seems a little more complicated, maybe.
No, it's not.
It's not.
It is
just the feeling of having a mana that's
yes.
worth three.
It's essentially like I do not like the deck. It is extremely inconsistent.
Really?
Mm-hmm.
I guess from what for whatever reason, I was catching like three different like MTGO. What are they called?
I have not played against it on MTGO. You know,
well,
ever.
Like you pay $10 and you play a five game tournament like kind of like this.
Yeah, no, I do those all
the
time.
Yeah, but like I came across like one. I went 4-1 because it was like literally like two regular Storm and two Lotus Storm decks. And like you just with my sideboard, like how we play sideboard because of all the other decks.
Yeah.
It wasn't too bad, but like Lotus Storm was just like I just didn't understand. Like the first time I came across it, I was like, "What the fuck is this? Like, what
it's
are they
like,
doing?"
It's like Mono Blue Tron. It's the lesser of
a
the
lot
two.
Of pieces to put
it's
together.
A lot of pieces to put for one puzzle.
Well, hey, I mean, some people like. I mean, that's what people liked about KCI, you know. Like, except it was like really.
It was
strong,
abusive, is the issue.
But like, it had a huge learning curve to like understand how the deck worked.
I mean, that's why I like Storm, but Twiddle Storm is just very different.
What's it called?
Twiddle Storm.
Oh yeah, because it has that. That is so confusing, especially on MTGO. It's not like there's you play it quick. Like I just don't know what's happening. I'm like I know what to hit for a counter, and I know what to play on my turn, but like, man, it throws me for a freaking loop.
Yeah, it's very different.
Okay. Like regular Storm, I can manage.
Yeah, because people have learned, even people who don't play Storm regularly, have learned what
it's
to do
simple enough to play. Like you know what you're looking out for, and when they're about to go off. I mean, some decks they just gotta beat it. But that's well, I like Merfolk. It can be a little. Conservative sometimes.
Yes. I mean, it's kind of like GDS.
GDS?
Versus Death Shadow.
Merfolk is not like that.
It is in the aspect that it is more of a tempo deck.
I have no removal. That's like...
Okay, but you have Force of Negation. actively.
Well,
and you have active counter spells. And both decks are tempo based.
Sure. Well, in very different ways.
Yeah,
like,
in different
Death
ways.
Shadow seems to, like, well, especially Grixis is like an attrition. Because they're, like, trying to take all your cards out your hand. Merfolk is just like, I'm going to jam creatures and I'm going to counter the important stuff and hope for the win.
Yeah.
Grixis is like, I hope I find my creatures because I'll only have 12 at most. Right? For Grixis is 12.
Usually. Yeah.
Yeah. They're different. I love playing against Grixis. I always have the advantage, I feel like.
Yes. I would say that Merfolk definitely has the advantage over Grixis just because of the value of the cards. But
yeah, and I don't kill myself.
Right.
All I have to do is, like, build an alpha and then just, you know, don't die to... Did you, mole?
Yeah.
Benthic pass.
Go ahead.
Untap.
attack for one.
19.
Let's go. Island. Alright, chalice on one.
Sure.
Pass turn. One.
Yeah. I'll take three. I'll be at 16
now.
16. Play Electromancer.
Mm-hmm.
Go ahead.
Graph Digger's Cage?
Sure.
Two mana. Play Lord. Attack for two. Island Walk.
Yeah. 14. Pass turn.
Have you drawn yet?
No, I haven't, but I'd make the mana. I do both at the same time.
Yeah, yeah. If I counter...
No, if you're going to counter, you have to do it before I declare the mana.
Okay, okay. That's fine.
Test for ritual.
Okay.
You gain 10 life.
Yeah.
Burst counters.
Yeah. 14. You have four cards in hand.
Yeah. I've cast 1, 2, 3 so far.
Three so far. Force, exiling force.
Sure.
All right.
All right. In response to the force.
Okay.
Other force is still exiled. We're gonna spend a red and cast Manmorphos, make a red and a blue. All
right.
Four. This is still in the stack. Draw four. All right. This gets countered.
Okay.
This is. Storm counters at 5 because you cast Force. Playing for turn. Barrel, Storm counter 6. Use the red. Grape shot trigger. 6 copies. 1 here. 2 here for you.
Okay.
I will swing 2 and
my
deal
15?
14 because you pinged yourself with Fiery Islet.
Alright.
And I'll hit you for 2.
Okay.
So 13.
Or 12, right? I was at 15. Okay.
14, yeah, 14.
Yeah, and then minus 2. Okay.
Yeah, go ahead.
Alright, on top. Draw. Pass turn.
move to combat?
Before you move to combat. Let's do trickster targeting this guy.
Swing two.
Let's take the two for now.
You're at 10. Go ahead.
Alright. Tap. One card. Take one, master waves, make three tokens.
Yep.
Attack for two.
We'll join you at 12.
Oh, faster. Attack for two, four, six, eight. Attack for eight.
Block a trickster, block a token.
Okay.
I'll take four.
And then play an island for turn,
sure,
and pass. Chalice on two.
Yep.
Oh my god. I forgot to dig up.
Go to five?
I
last turn.
Go ahead.
Play Waterlog.
Sure.
Sack. Draw. Okay. Swing four. Wait, you took two that turn, right?
Yep, I'm at three.
I didn't play land that turn, did I?
You played the Waterlogged.
That's right. Yeah, that's tapped and sacked it. Okay. Alright, pass turn. Tapped. Pass turn.
Go ahead.
And tap. Let's see. Okay.
What does it do?
It's a 2/2/1 flyer.
I was trying to grape shot.
Kind of hit soft lock there, huh?
No, not... yes and no, because the grape shot, the storm trigger still happens, and I still get to get the copies.
Yeah.
So I could have also drawn another one of these, and I would have just... I had cards in hand to just
so
do
you
could about...
just go at it.
Yeah, I could have done...
You just needed, like, one more turn?
I needed to find another one of these.
Oh.
And I needed to have grape shot.
Kind of turned into... drawing.
Yeah, I also saw no sideboard cards, which did not help.
Yeah.
When you opened with two of them.
Yeah. Well, three. Because it was like chalice.
Oh, yeah, it was
chalice on one, and
but
then next turn.
Yeah. The last chalice was just insult to injury at that point.
Yeah. Well, I mean, I wasn't going to risk it. Because, I mean, you have a lot of, like, two drops as well.
Yeah, no, I know. I'm not saying risk it. I'm saying, like, it's the proper play.
Oh, yeah. Oh, my God. I know what you mean. At that point, I was like, felt a lot. So I wanted to get the graph just so you couldn't start digging up your.
I had a passive cleanse in my hand the whole game.
That's why I found against storm, you get the graph is like priority, and then it's a chalice on one, and then chalice on two.
Yes.
And like anything after that, you just save your counter spells.
Yeah, and I'm not running pieces of the puzzle anymore. Otherwise, that would have really helped.
It can be a tough match either way. Just into all.
Yeah, I mean, it's like. It's a lot like the humans match too. It's
I'm not gonna. Maybe humans and merfolk is favored a little bit, especially with like forces starting. But it can go either way. Like if I don't have the answers, you're just gonna
merfolk
storm
is,
me out.
Yeah, merfolk is. It's a pretty even match. I would not say that either deck is like super favored, but I would say that like humans has a level to it with more hate than merfolk does against storm.
Yeah. I don't know, that's one of the things I do like about Merfolk is that it can be very well rounded.
Yeah.
Like it's like a jack of all trades, master of none kind of situation.
Yeah, absolutely.
But like, dude, they got they have that one, like a couple of guys who have like ridiculous win rates with Merfolk just because they're so experienced with the deck.
Yeah.
And I wouldn't, you know, I enjoy the deck. It's not like ridiculously broken. It's fun to play. It's got a nice learning curve to it. I enjoy it. I'm happy to. Play it, and it's not expensive. It's not super expensive.
Yes.
At least with chalices, like I'm planning.